A very good morning, dear students. I, Seema Sharma, your English teacher, is here with the poetry, A Laughing Song. This particular poem is a wonderful piece written by William Blake. And the most important feature which I like the most about this poem is that this poem is based about happiness. It's about laughter. And the beauty of the poem is that William Blake has tried to find out everything around him laughing with happiness. Now, as we explore the first two stanzas of the poem, you will notice that how everything around us laughs with happiness, but hardly we notice it. But yes, of course, the poet's eyes are very, very keen, and he has noticed the nature smiling with happiness. So first of all, I'll be reading out to you the first two stanzas of the poem, and while I do so, I want you all to focus on the pronunciation of how to recite this particular poem. And after that, I shall be explaining to you all each and every line of the given two stanzas. So here it begins like this. A Laughing Song by William Blake. When the green woods laugh with the voice of joy, and the dimpling streams runs laughing by, when the air does laugh with our merry wit, and the green hills laugh with the voice of it, when meadows laugh with the lively green, and the grasshopper laughs in the merry scene, when Mary and Susan and Emily with their sweet round mouths sing ha ha he. So this is the way you're going to pronounce the first two stanzas of the poem. And now let's move to the explanation part of it. So let's see what the first two lines have in store for us. When the green woods laugh with the voice of joy. In these two lines, what the poet is trying to say us, woods refers to forests. And he is saying that when he sees the hills that are green because of trees on it, because of forests on it, he feels that the hills are laughing with greenery. And they seem to be very lively, they seem to be very happy. Then he says, and the dimpling streams runs laughing by. Now, what do you understand by dimpling or dimples? Dimpling word has come out from the word dimples. If you have noticed, sometimes some people when they smile, see, when I smile, my cheeks are quite plain and you hardly see anything on my cheeks, right? But there are some people when they smile, out here you will find some spots. You will feel as if a hole is going inside. So that is referred as dimples. So when this skin goes inside the mouth, when you put a smile on your face, that's called dimples. And out here, what is streams? Streams, we can say, are natural sources of water, but they are smaller than the river. So we see that a stream is running out here. So what happens when we smile? Sometimes some people have dimples on their faces. Out here, the poet is imagining this curve out here of the river. He is imagining this curve as a dimple falling on the face of this stream. I hope it's clear. See, the stream is turning out here, having a hole out here inside. It is moving inside in this particular portion, and this is referred as dimpling stream. So when the poet sees this wavy movements of the stream, he feels that even the stream is smiling and it is having dimples on its face. Then we have, when the air does laugh with our merry wit. So what the poet is imagining, that if we notice at times when the air blows around us, so what happens? We hear the rustling sound of the wind in our ears, right? So that rustling sound, he imagines that even because of some humorous thing happening, even the air is laughing. And the green hills laugh with the voice of it. So what the poet is saying, that when the air moves, you will notice when the air moves, it also shakes the hilltops like this. Even the trees are moving with it. The trees are also showing a movement. So what happens? What the poet is imagining? The poet is imagining that as the air moves, as the air is rustling down, so that time what is happening? Even the trees on the hills are, what are they doing? Even they are laughing. So in the first stanza, we notice that what are the things according to the poet that are laughing? It is the woods that are laughing. Second thing, the streams are laughing. So we have the green woods, the trees are laughing, the stream is laughing. And what else? When meadows laugh with the lively green. So what is meadows? Meadows are green grasslands. The green area like this, where we are having trees, where we are having grasses, we are having flowers out here also, trees. And then we have the small weeds out there, several insects, just like you can see the butterfly out here. So several insects are there, and that portion is referred as the meadows. So you will notice that even when the air moves, even the meadows shake their heads like this with the flow of the air. And what the poet imagines it as, the poet feels that even the stream is smiling. Next, what the poet is saying, and the grasshopper laughs in the merry scene. So out here I have drawn a grasshopper for you. I hope you can see. It's wearing a beautiful orange cap as well. So you will notice that when we see the meadows, we find different sort of insects in it as well. Like I have drawn the butterfly out here for you. So butterflies, grasshoppers, other insects you find. And when you find these insects in the meadows, the poet is imagining that even the insects living in the meadows are as happy as the meadows. And just as the meadows are shaking in the air and laughing, similarly the insects residing in this particular meadows are also very, very happy. When Mary and Susan and Emily, so the poet basically is referring to the children. Although he has used three specific names in this poem, yet out here these names do not personify any particular person the poet knows, yet these are commonly referring to children. And what is he saying? That even he has seen that when sweet children, just like my sweet, sweet students, the way you smile when you say ha ha he, the way you smile, your round faces, they look so pretty. Similarly, what the poet has noticed, that like the nature looks so extremely beautiful when the nature is laughing. Similarly, when children are laughing, they are also looking very happy. They are looking very nice. And when he sees the children laughing, the poet feels that even the children are singing the song of ha ha he. So here it is. The first two stanzas of the poem are laughing song. I hope I have been able to clarify the meaning of each and every word as well as any line. In case you have any queries, you are free to ask me when we meet together, when we meet each other in our online classes. I hope you have enjoyed the session. I miss you, dear students. God bless you all.